In this video documentation, I'm going to walk you through a couple of different parameters that developers can pass into their applications to help better troubleshoot and work with their applications. Now, you know, it's no question that Empower developers want and need to better understand, you know, why their Empower apps aren't working as expected when that time arises. Now, from our tech support line, you know, we notice a few issues that come up frequently. You know, one, generated applications aren't returning the results that the developer expects. A second one could be dashboard applications don't render as expected. And even a third, developers, you know, are trying to better understand what parameters they can pass into their apps, and they're not always sure which ones are available. So I want to take some time here and talk through a couple of really helpful parameters that can help solve both of these problems. And those are the debug parameter and the help parameter. So let's step down first and talk about the debug parameter. In particular, the debug is a great way when turned on to be able to see a lot of behind the scenes of what's going on in your application. In particular, what SQL statement we generated to run to get your result set, as well as what database we're connecting to, and some database performance metrics. You have two ways to be able to turn this feature on. One option is to turn it on and basically leave it on, and that is available via application properties. So I'll go ahead and click on application properties for this app, and then I can go and find the debug parameter and set that to yes. So now debugging will remain on, and I'll show you what that debugging looks like here by rerunning the application. And that debug will always stay on until I go back in and turn it off. So if you're debugging an application for a while and know that it'll need to be turned on for a while, feel free to set that and then you turn it off when you're done. An alternative to that, when you only need that debug to just turn on one time, I'm gonna go ahead here and turn it back off. So now it's off, it's kind of back to how it normally is. But let's say I just need to turn it on kind of ad hoc. What I can do is in the URL, I can just run the application as normal, and then I can add into the URL a question mark debug equals one. Now the debug information will stay on until I navigate away from this page or close my browser, and then it's back off. So two ways to be able to enable that basic debugging equals one feature. So debug basically turned on there to see the SQL information. Now, turning the page there on debug equals one, there's a second parameter that we can pass into to the debug a parm that's going to give us some advanced debugging methods. It's really helpful when we're dealing with dashboard or imported applications. So to better understand the dashboards, if you're not quite sure, it's really just a collection of various applications that are painted together and passing parameters along the way. So in the example I'm going to show you here, this is a really simple application, but it's just a customer listing. And you'll see that last column is a state description. And in my case, I happen to import that from another app. Now, you wouldn't know that just by looking at the application, but if I come up to the URL and add debug equals two to the URL, you'll see that the state there changes. It goes away, and instead it shows me the debug information, and it shows me exactly the URL that Empower used to go out and get that sub application to bring it back to, you know, to go out and get that child application to go out and get and bring back into the parent. So that can only be turned on at an ad hoc level. That's not going to be able to be turned on in the app properties like I showed before. But in either case, debug one or debug equals two, really good features for developers to try to better understand what's happening in their applications. Now, I did mention help equals one, and I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about that a little bit more. What we also find from a support site is developers come in and they say, you know, golly gee, there's a lot of parameters that I can pass to my app, and I just have no idea which ones I can, you know, which ones are available. So at runtime, you can simply add help equals one to your URL, and based on the template that you have selected and the fields that are there, we will generate for you a whole parm sheet that you can see all the parameters that the application allows. So if you wanted to do some, you know, default ad hoc, some default sorting, or you wanted to pass in some additional filters along the URL, you could do that here. So for instance, I'll do just that here. I'll add in a filter relationship here for one of my fields. And notice that as I click it up in the top section, you see that we actually generate that URL for you. So we construct that parameterized URL, and you can click run URL, and we just simply copy that and take that up into the URL for you there to then copy and paste and be put in a menu. So overall, debugging, the debug parameter and the help parameter, really great tools for a developer who's trying to better understand their application or work through any problems that may come up.